Now this is truly, for me anyways, one of the most beautiful spots that I've encountered if I were going to grind acorn and prepare food. Look at the scenery behind me, it's majestic. And right over here, look at this, right over here is a small grinding bowl. And look at this, this is the actual grinding stone, okay? This is the pestle. It's broken, but you can see it right over here. And this is how they would prepare the acorn, or maybe use it to soften an abalone shell or a mussel. But look at this, it is just absolutely gorgeous. Look at this, the vista is spectacular. One of the things that I had mentioned earlier was to have a good village site, you needed to have fresh water. And here it is, this creek running down from the Santa Lucia Mountains, okay, providing one of the elements necessary for life. So again, we have the vast Pacific Ocean with its food resources that are spectacular, okay? We have fresh water. We have a very nice flat location for a village. Yes, life at that time for the Rumsen Indians must have been pretty good. But look, good. Here's the creek that runs down from the Santa Lucia Mountains, and it comes down here, and look, it tumbles into the ocean. I'll walk slowly here and take you to the precipice. And look at this. Isn't this absolutely gorgeous? Look at this right over here. There it is. There's the creek falling into the ocean. Such a majestic view. It's unbelievable. This is really a joy to behold. But look at this. When I came down here, I stepped on this boulder here. And I noticed the shadow over here. You're not going to believe this. Look at this. This is an ancient grinding boulder, which used to be up here. And over time, it got pushed down to here. This is really fantastic, because all the bedrock mortars that I have seen have been in the ground on a big granite piece. This element right over here can actually be, I guess, portable, if you want to say that. So this is really, really fantastic. Let's go in there and take a real close look here. This here is very, very smooth. Very smooth. Very smooth. And you can see over here, let me get in the shadows, right over here. It's a flat spot right over there. Okay, let me clear it out. And right over here, look, it's a flat spot. So they could have used this to break open the acorn. But there it is. That is wonderful. That's really majestic. So again, this is the area where the Rumsen Indians. What's unique about this little waterfall is right over here. Look, it's like a natural wall. And it's about 4 feet, 3-4 feet deep over here. So you could actually sit in there like a thermal bath. Wow, this is very, very, very beautiful. And look at this element over here. This here is grooved here, very smooth. This is extremely smooth. So right over here, look, this over here is a little concave. You probably can't see it. So you can crush the nut here. And again, as part of the leaching and cleaning process, you needed fresh water, and there it was. So this also is another food preparation boulder, food preparation site. This is absolutely fantastic. Okay, there's a grinding boulder, okay? There's one on that spot, and I'm standing right here on this spot where the waterfall is. And it's just absolutely incredible, okay? Absolutely incredible. Is that large boulder by the stream that had the grinding bowls in there. But if you follow the stream, you'll notice this big flat boulder over here. We'll take a walk to it. And you can see a little bit of sand here. So that indicates there's a depression here forming on this boulder. Now I want to show you over here. This is kind of a rough surface. And right over here, it's starting to become smooth. So what I'm going to do is clear out this area, and we're going to take a look to see if this is what they refer to as more of a grinding slick. Over there in a mortar, they use the pounding action. And on a place like this, they would use an action this way. They would use a stone, which in Mexico they call a matate, but it would be ground this way. So this area right here will probably be clear, but I'm going to get a brush, I'm going to get a tree branch and clear it off, and let's take a look.
Okay, look at this.
As I'm cleaning this here, this area, the sand, you can actually see the outline right over here. This is the outline of where the grinding area was. It's interesting how just moving the sand can show you. Look at this right over here. Right over here. Okay. You can actually see the configuration of the grinding area. Okay. So what I'm going to do is finish cleaning it off, but I can actually see this outline right over here. I can actually see a differentiation right over here. So let me continue clearing and let's see how it looks after I pour a little water on it. Well, this is really great. I've taken some water and look, okay, here's the boulder. Now, if you look at this boulder, it has a dark black color. But this dark coloring here is actually plant life, okay? It's organic material, a form of lichen or lichen. Okay, now right over here, look at this. This is where the sandy area was, okay? This is where the sandy area is. And you'll notice right here is the configuration of where the grinding occurred. Now what's fantastic about this is you can see the difference in color, okay? And what has happened in a grinding action, okay, the boulder has been smoothed out really, really fine grain, whereas over here, it's rough, okay? And this is where the plants can anchor themselves. This has been ground down to such a fine grain that there's nowhere for the plant life to actually anchor itself. This is really a fabulous little discovery. So here we have this grinding boulder. This is the action that they were using for this grinding boulder. And right over there is the deep mortar where they would use a pestle. Okay, the stone that they would use over there for the grinding action was a large stone, maybe 6-12 inches in length, and they would pound away. Over here, they would use a stone that was not too much bigger than a hand, and they would go this way. Okay, they would go this way to grind it out. So this is really a fabulous little discovery. This again is another example, okay, of a cliff face that has worn away. And you can see, okay, these little white specks over here. Those are remnants of the shells, okay, that were discarded by the Rumsen Indians. And some of these go 2-3 feet deep. There was a shell midden site in Santa Barbara area on the San Miguel Island where they dug down just about a foot. And the shell that they recovered from that, I guess, experiment was 7,000 years old. So you can imagine that this site that we're looking at right now that has 2 to 3 to 4 foot layers of strata of discarded shells to form the shell midden site is a very, very old site. Now before me we have these ancient abalone shells. Look at this. I'll tell you what, This is really, really wonderful because we're not looking at shells here, abalone shells that we bought in the store. These are ancient ones harvested by the original inhabitants of this area, known as the Rumsen Indians. And this is really, really something else. This area is acres upon acres of shells. So to create a system or an area where you have such an abundant discarded shell life, you know it takes thousands of years for that to occur. Thousands. Well, this is interesting, you know. Beautiful places, you know, keep getting reused as time goes along. So at one time we know that the Rumsen Indians lived here. But as I was walking along the cliff face, I found an area where modern man that came after the Rumsen Indians, used this area in some fashion like the Indians did. He created his own midden, his own dumb site. And I'm near a cliff face that is partially washed away. And I'm going to show you what I found, modern man's midden, modern man's dump, so to speak. So let's take a look at it. Look at this over here. This here is coming off from the ground level up here. So here's the runoff. Look, there are signs that this area was at one time used as a dump. Look at this. Here's a partial plate. Okay, let's take a look at this plate. Look at this. Here's an old plate. Okay, look at these. These are bottles over here. Bottles. And you can see layers. There's a bottle right there. And this is what's interesting. There's a bottle right there. Okay, and below it there's some kind of metal container. And this is the, you know, what's interesting about this, what we're looking at is no different than what we would look at a 1,000 or 5,000 year old shell midden. You would see layers of life, okay? And over here, look at this. There's a bottle, there's a metal piece next to it. Right over here, look at this. There's a lamp cord, here's a plastic bottle. There's a can right over here. Let's go around and take a real close look. And you can see the layering over here. Look, here's an old battery cable. Here's another electrical implement. So, you know, you have over here, possibly over 100 or 200 years worth of modern man's life. We might find bottles. There's a jar. Look at this jar right over here. This jar could be from the 1930s. There's an old shoe over here. Look at this. That's an old shoe right there. So at one time, look at this right over here. There's a bottle right up there. Do you see that? So this is in the excavations what we would do for the ancient sites. You would cut across, okay, and then you could see layers, okay, some of them thousands of years old of their lifestyle, so to speak. There's a metal piece right over here. Look at this. There's a pipe. And as the washout occurs over here, look at this at my feet. Look at this old bottle over here. This bottle is, well, look at this. It says Lavoris, okay? Lavoris, I think, was a mouthwash. So this is really an interesting find. Look at these bottles over here. Look at these. Look at this old one over here. It says this is a quart bottle, okay? Look at this. So they wash down here and then finally into the ocean, okay? And the interesting thing about ancient Indian shell middens, those are particular to shells, but there's also sites that, you know, we'll just call middens. And this is where not only they put their shells, but the trash, the refuse from their life. So on this spot, we will find ancient shell middens. We'll find ancient middens that were used as trash dumps, and we have now also found modern man's midden, modern man's trash dump. So in a lot of ways, this has been really exciting. Well, I'm just east of the village, the Rumsen site that we were looking at by the ocean. Behind me, or right here, is the stream that flows through the middle of the Rumsen village. Okay, by the ocean. But apparently, right here along this stream, there's many other grinding mortars. I'm going to show you what I saw Okay, I came up on this boulder and I saw this little indentation here. This here is another Indian grinding area. Let me clear it out for you. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Now, I'm not sure if there's anything here, but let's clear it out over here and let's see if there was another area right over here. That, oh, look at this. Oh my goodness. You are seeing this. You are seeing this exactly as I discover this. This is incredible. Look at this. This is really wonderful. We have the small grinding area and then a larger, deeper one over here. Well, friends, I'll tell you, this is what finding lost civilizations is all about. It's finding little clues, receiving bits of information from people that lived here. Now, the person that told me about this boulder owns this ranch area where the ancient Rumsen village used to be, and he knows some of its history. And he told me, as a young boy running around here all up and down the stream, the creek bed, he found grinding mortars and pestles. So he shared this little bit of information with me, and I'm so happy to have found this boulder that he shared it with me, and so now that I can share it with you. Well, it's been a wonderful day, and I hope you've enjoyed visiting this ancient Rumsen Indian site as much as I have. Now, at this location, the Rumsen Indians no longer live. However, as a tribe, they still survive, and they're working effortlessly to regain their past, their history, and their language. So I hope in this small journey that we've taken, that we can all learn something.